Hey everyone, this is Brian, and today I'm going to reset and repot an angel wing begonia. Now this thing is a mess right now because I knew months ago that I was going to reset it, and I haven't been watering it or taking very good care of it since the summer. So it does look pretty raggedy here, but we are going to reset the pot and use some cuttings off of this existing plant to start a new one. Now getting this thing out of the pot, I don't care about being careful just because I know I'm going to reset the thing and I can do it with cuttings. So it doesn't matter if I rip the plant to pieces. I'm just trying to get it out as aggressively and quickly as possible. So now that I have it out, I'm going to start by putting the cans back in the pot and reuse those. I have a bunch of extra loose dirt here on the ground from some of the other pot work I did today. So I'm using that and any of the organic matter laying around to start filling the pot back up. Now I also have a second pot that I'm going to create another begonia in. So at this time I get that pot ready too. So I'll have two pots that I'm going to be putting cuttings in to create two plants. Now the taller pot has less perlite in it because I'm going to stick that begonia in a spot where it will get direct sunlight on sunny days. Putting in less perlite means that more moisture will be retained in the soil, which is going to help the begonia survive and thrive in the direct light. Now, I've had such good luck propagating angel wing begonias with cuttings that I'm going to push the limit a little bit here and see if it makes any difference. In this case, I'm just breaking off pieces from the old plant. I would normally use scissors and make good clean cuts, but if you know me at all, I like to experiment. Let's see if it actually makes a difference. I'm just tearing them apart and dropping these cuttings into the soil. We'll see how it goes. I've also chosen to add a few longer pieces instead of just everything being short cuttings. With the pots now full, I can move them back inside. Once they're in place, I give all the cuttings a drink, and now we'll wait. Be sure to like and subscribe to follow the updates on this and other tropical plants indoors and out in cold weather environments.